Hey everyone, it's Carly the Pink Scrapper, and today I am going to be talking all about embossing folders. So what you see in front of you right now is my embossing folder collection, and this is a great organizer. I believe it's by Darice, which is D-A-R-I-C-E, and I got it on Amazon quite a while ago, and if I can find the link, I will put it down in this description box below for you so you can check it out. But I really love this folder. I do have two of them, and it just keeps me organized. And it even has my small ones in here by Tim Holtz, and just put a couple in a pocket. The only thing that sometimes I run into is that it's sewn right down the middle, and sometimes those can come apart. And so you just kind of have to be mindful of how you are with your folders, but otherwise it's a great way to organize your embossing folders. So I'm going to put this to the side and show you some embossing that I've done. What I'm going to show you is mostly Crafter's Companion embossing folders. They've come out with some great ones that actually I'll show you this one. I believe this one is a 3D embossing folder, and it has the die cut, actually just the dies inside of here. And so when you place your paper in there and run it through your machine, your die cutting machine, I have the Gemini MIDI that just came out. So this is what this one looked like, and see, it's showing up great on camera. This is a kind of pastel green mirror paper that is from, I believe this is from Garden of Love. So I've already taken out the middle here, but you can see how gorgeous that is. And you just do it in one run or one pass through your die cut machine, and it's done. And so that is a gorgeous one. This one is actually a 3D, and what I do is I just write down the name with a Sharpie, because most of the time I don't tend to keep the packaging. Although on the Gemini or Crafter's Companion products, I do like to keep them. I just cut the top off, and then on this one, I can slip it right in. I did have these all in a bundle out of the packaging, and I found that for me, I'm such a visual person that just having this little piece right here to show you what it is, I just like it, and everything's pretty uniform. And so I can put this in a shoebox or something like that, and they're just organized to me. So anyway, so this one is the 3D Regency Swirls, and this is a great one to show you the example of what 3D is. So I don't know if you can see it on camera. I think you can. I'll find another one. Let me see if I have it here. Oh, here it is. Okay, so I'll show you this one. You can see how deep that etches, and actually you can feel it, you can really feel the difference. And so on this one, this is what a regular die would look like. This is a Crafter's Companion one, but it's not a 3D folder like this one. So hopefully you can see what the difference is. I really like the 3D folders better because of that deep etch. So this one, this is what the embossing looks like. It's still gorgeous, I mean, but look at this one. So you can see that depth of that right there. So still gorgeous. What I did here is I took some pastel green cardstock from the Garden of Love collection, and then with my finger, I just used the Crafter's Companion gilding wax, and this is the Empire Gold one. So, and you do get so much in here, and it lasts so long. I mean, look how much. And you really don't use a lot when you are doing a technique like this. So, and what I'm going to do later, I'm going to go through all these different embossing folders with you and show you what they look like, but then I'll come back and I will show you the cards that I've made with most of them. So anyway, these two are gonna go together. All right, so the next one I wanna show you is this one right here. This one's called the Lion Frame, and I'm not quite sure what collection that one's from. But on this one, you can see I use this gorgeous glitter paper. This is from Crafter's Companion, and what I love is that you can run your finger over and there's no glitter on it. But one of the things I wanna point out on this glitter paper is that when you are taking out the pieces here, when you're breaking it apart from the, you know, the other outside layer of your paper, you want to make sure that you are pulling away from you. So like, if I'm gonna take this out, I'm gonna pull it away like this. If you pull it this way towards you, you're gonna get something that looks like this. And I'm not worried about that because I have this mentality that it's just paper and I can put a flower or embellishment or something over that. So this is not something that I will throw away. And what I normally do is I'll take the inside piece and I'll turn it over, and then you can stamp on it or you can put a different background on it. So you'll see some of my pieces here will have the piece already turned around. All right, so that goes, oops, that's gonna go like that with that one. All right, so the next one that I want to show you is this one right here. Now this one is called Ornate Lace, and this is another 3D die. Embossing folder. You can see, look at that, it's so awesome. And it's really, really deep. And so, on the 3D embossing folders, this can just go, put your paper in the middle and it can go directly into your Gemini MIDI. You don't even need the plastic purple shim that goes with it. So I love that because it makes it so much faster and easier. So this is what I embossed. And then I stickled it up. I have this stickles that's almost out on the very bottom, but I managed to get enough out of there. And look at that gorgeous glitter. I love it. So this one is a super, super popular one. It's called Studded Leather. And look at this. And this is actually a 3D die, or not 3D die, it's a 3D embossing folder as well. And look at that. I don't know if you can see it, but it is. I mean, just when you run your hand over it, you can just feel it. So this is one that, this one I got on Amazon, believe it or not, because it was so hard to find. But when I looked on Amazon, there it was. I was really excited about it. So this next one is called, this is what it's called, Biarritz Frame. And this is what it looks like. Isn't that just gorgeous? Now, let me put it together like this. I thought that these two colors, since they're from the same collection, that they would do great together. So I'm gonna make a gorgeous card with this. All right, and here's some more. This one is called Nature's, this is a Nature's Garden. I think this is a 3D. It feels like it, but this is what it looks like. It has that glitter paper, and the glitter paper is fairly thick. So what I usually do is I try to fit a whole sheet of paper in here, but you see down here I don't have enough, but I'm gonna trim this down a little bit. There's actually a line that I can follow, so that's what's gonna happen with that one. This one is a newer one because they started putting this foam in there so that your middle sheet here, whoops, your middle sheet here just pops right out and it doesn't get stuck inside of that metal die. So you see I used this washi tape and I just taped that on there so I don't lose it. This is another great one. It's called Trellis Vines, but it's with the Peony collection. gorgeous collection. And I think this is a couple years old as well. But look how beautiful that is. This is a mirrored green color. And then here's the insert that goes in here. You can always take it out and then place it onto another kind of paper or your card background, something like that would be cute too. So sky's the limit. What I love about embossing folders is they're so easy. Put your paper in there and put it through your machine and it's done. And you have such an elegant look in a little amount of time. All right, so this one is called Venetian Lace and it's by the Vintage Lace Collection. This one is very elegant looking. And here's the other side. And it looks like this side is the raised side. So you can see it. I could take, like I said, some white acrylic paint with my finger and then get all those areas just to make them pop. But I kind of like it just how it is. And then my last one is also, it has the dye inside of it. Gorgeous. This one's called Province Frame by Vintage Lace. And look at this. So beautiful. And this is a matte gold paper by Crafter's Companion as well. One of the things I love about Crafter's Companion, and you can see this white side is just as gorgeous, is a lot of times when you buy the collection bundles, you get all the matching paper, and you might get some mirrored paper or some vellum, and it's just like Christmas every time. So anyways, I'm going to pause this video. I'm going to come back and show you what you can do with embossed fake paper that you've done. So I'll be right back. If you remember, this is the silver one. That was the glitter card. And then here's a pastel green mirrored card, both of those by Crafter's Companion. And then I made it into an easel card. And it's probably a little hard to see because I zoomed in on my camera, but that's what it looks like. So this is what I ended up making. I think it came out super cute. This card was actually pretty large. It was like 6 3/4 inch. So pretty big for me anyways. This one is the Christmas embossing folder with the mirrored gold paper. And then I guess, again, using Anna Griffin's pre-made flowers and stuff, made this card. And generally, I don't put anything on the inside because I like people to write a note in their own handwriting. I think that is really special and personalized when you do that. So that's actually what I do, and generally put the sentiment on the top. This one has two of the embossed papers that I did. This pastel pink and then the mirrored one there. And this was one of those 3D folders that had the die cut. So it cut out that oval in the middle. I think it came out super cute. And the next one I made into a wedding card because when I started to put it together, it just looked like wedding. So this one has, this was the embossed heart / die cut in there. And I put some doily on the back, paper doily, and then just flowers and a bow. See how easy that is? And look how elegant it makes it look. Okay, so this one I think is probably my favorite. And this one was the one that I put stickles on. I embossed it with a 3D embossing folder and then put my clear glitter stickles on. And then this was a separate embossed die. You can't see the embossing on it unless you look really close. And then just put it on. This is actually a pre-cut base by Anna Griffin. And I think it came out pretty cute. And you can see the quality of the Anna Griffin card bases. All right, so this one is the green, pastel green mirrored paper by Crafter's Companion. I did put a Crafter Companion paper in that oval back there. And then this one is Crafter's Companion from that same product that I was telling you. And then this one's Anna Griffin. So you can see they combine really, really easily again. And this is Anna Griffin card base. All right, so this one, if you remember, this is the green emboss, and I put that gold gilding wax on there, and then I backed some white just to make the papers stand out against from each other. And then here's another mirrored paper and just flowers, ribbon, and some pearls. And see how awesome and elegant that is. So I guess my point is, you can see that what a difference the embossing makes in your cards. So it's motivating me to use them more often. And there are other things that you can do with your embossing folders. If you'd like to see another video of that, leave a comment down below. And if there's interest in it, then I will do a second video about embossing folders. So they're just fun. I think a lot of times they can be forgotten about, but look how gorgeous it makes it. Thanks for watching, guys. As always, I do appreciate you, and I hope to see you next time. Bye.